Hi, this is Matthew Stout from the CCDC. Today, I would like to show you how to use the Crystal Packing Similarity tool under CSD-Materials. Let's get started. The Crystal Packing Similarity tool can grade one or more reference structures to one or more comparison structures and quantifies the degree to which these are similar. It does this by identifying how many molecules within a reference cluster match the associated cluster of the comparison structure by overlaying them. The more molecules that overlay within a set of geometric tolerances, the more similar the packing is between the structures. This is best used with structures with the same or very similar molecular makeup, as otherwise it takes a very high amount of computational power and time. This tool can be used to separate polymorphs from a list of crystals of a similar molecular makeup and identify isostructurality in solvates, salt hydrates, and co-crystals. It can also be used to find an experimentally observed structure from within a list of predicted structures. Let's have a look at how to use it. First, you will open Mercury using your desktop icon. Then, on the top level menu, go to CSD Materials, Search, and Crystal Packing Similarity. This will bring up a window which will allow you to choose which structures you would like to compare. You can do this by either clicking Select and adding refcode lists, conquest hits, or Mercury files of saved structures, or you can add your structures by clicking Add refcode, as we will today. The system we'll investigate here is paracetamol and its refcode family HXACAM. So first, we will add the reference structures by clicking Add refcode, typing in HXACAM, and because we want to compare the whole family, we'll click Enter refcode family here. We'll then tick OK, OK. We'll then do the same with the comparison structures, click Add refcode as it's already typed in, the box is already ticked, we'll again click OK and OK. Now we have the entire paracetamol refcode family in both the reference structures and in the comparison structures. If at this point you would like to compare the two with the default settings, you can click Compare. However, today we will click Next. The options here allow you to choose the packing shell size and the geometric tolerances. The packing shell size allows you to choose how many molecules are in a cluster. The geometric tolerances allow you to choose the angle and distance tolerance that you will allow when molecules overlay. If at any point you have changed these and would like to return them to the default settings, you can click Default here. Again, we will click Next. Finally, with these options, you are allowed to manipulate your search even further. However, again, if at any point you want to return them to default settings, you can click Default here. But now we will click Next. Here you can name your search. Here I will call it Example 1 and click Compare. This will take about a minute. There will be a progress bar which appears in the bottom right hand corner of the screen. Once that reaches 100%, that means the search is complete. Once the search is complete, you can save your results here by clicking Save Results and save them as a search summary file or the search file. You can also save your results by using the drop-down window under Options on the right-hand side of the screen here and clicking Save As to bring you to the same window. The molecule that you can see on the screen currently is an overlay of HXACAN and HXACAN01. As you can see, only 1 out of 15 molecules is in common. That means that only one molecule was able to overlay, and that's the one you can see in the screen in front of you. If you go down below the list, you can see reference. So if you click reference, it will show you the reference structure. Comparison, it will show you the comparison structure where all of the carbons have been changed to green. This means that this molecule was able to successfully overlay. However, if you click show mismatches, it will show you all of the molecules that were not successfully able to overlay in pink. And if again you click on both, you're able to see the reference structure in all the default colours, the comparison structures that were able to overlay in green, and the comparison structures that were not able to overlay in pink. As you can see, this has an RMS of 0.091. As the lower the RMS, the less variance there is between the structures. Looking further at this list, by scrolling down, we can see that every refcode for each member of the paracetamol family has been compared as a reference structure and a comparison structure. If we then change to this comparison between HXA-CAN and HXA-CAN-08, this has 15 out of 15 molecules in common. If we click on that, we can see that all of the molecules are successfully overlaid. And if we click on comparison, we can see that they are all green. Finally, we can group by similarity by clicking this icon at the bottom right-hand side here. Using this method, the structures are formed into groups for which the packing patterns are highly similar. For the purposes of this grouping, structures with all of the same molecules in a cluster in common and are considered similar. Therefore, they have 15 out of 15 molecules for this example. Each grouping corresponds to a different polymorphic form for a compound. So in this case, all of group 3 is polymorphic form 1 for paracetamol, group 2 is polymorphic form 2, and group 1 is polymorphic form 3. You can also see that the space groups, densities, and by scrolling to the right, all of the cell parameters are shown for each individual refcode. You should now be able to use the packing similarity tool in Mercury. Thank you very much for watching.